Welcome, fans, to 2K Sports Thursday afternoon coverage of the NBA. Moments away, it'll be the Sacramento Kings going up against the Philadelphia 76ers at Wells Fargo Center. I'm Brian Anderson at the table with Grant Hill and Brent Berry. Our reporter is Allie LaForce. Let's take a look at the Western Conference standings now that the new year is upon us. Taking a look at Sacramento, they're in fifth place, right in the middle of the conference. Still time to improve that positioning.
Well, I think for the Kings, what's impressive is they've reached much of their potential this year. The big question, though, people are asking is, do they have what it takes to become a front runner?
They still had enough players take positive steps forward to call this season a success. Maybe they're not at the top of the standings where they'd hope they'd be, but they're in really good position in terms of the playoff picture.
Let's check out Sacramento's starting lineup. Fox and Herter man the guard spots. Murray and Sabonis are the bigs. And it's Barnes in at the small forward position. And for the 76ers, Harris and Embiid are in the middle. Maxey runs point with Melton at the two. And it's Batum in at the three, the small forward. Well, Brent, an interesting matchup here tonight, especially when you take a closer look at the center position.
Well, for the over 60 crowd, this is a fun one, B.A. It's not often that we highlight the center position as being the key matchup, but the big men on these teams, they deserve attention. It's going to be great watching them tonight.
Now here's Maxey. And here's Harris. Embiid, a screen on Murray. Here's Harris. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line. And the league's longest playoff drought was snapped last season by Sacramento. Light the beam, Brent.
Sweet, sweet relief, B.A. First postseason for the Kings since 2006. And they did it in such convincing fashion. I mean, these guys weren't coming in as if they had no chance. They came in confident and hungry, and they want to get back.
The free throw drops for Harris.
I feel like Tobias Harris's confidence has grown over the past couple seasons, especially on the offensive end. Very capable of taking advantage of smaller defenders.
Now here's Fox. We saw him with 19 his last time out. Embiid against Sabonis. Six to shoot. Here's Fox. And he knocks the jumper down.
Just getting more and more confident with that outside shot. Fox doesn't care how tight the defense is.
Maxey passes to Embiid. Back to Maxey. Harris on the wing. Offensive rebound. And Embiid with the power jam.
Woo, that was big time. I mean, a dunk contest finish from Embiid. This guy can fly.
And how about our AT&T 5G Slam Cam? Couldn't have captured that play any better. Almost 2 minutes into the first here. Now Fox. He's a tough guy to check, averaging almost 28 points a game. Outside Murray from behind the arc. It's hauled in by the Sixers. They come into this one following the loss to Atlanta.
I actually thought their execution at times was excellent, but they failed to come through in those important moments.
Well, they had the home fans worried for a little bit. I know that.
Herter passes to Sabonis. Fox with the ball. Outside Barnes. Shot clock at five. Sabonis with a screen on Batum. Here's Barnes. Oh, he sticks that one from 20 feet.
You got to have a player you can trust if you're going to call a number that involves a pick and roll. And Harrison Barnes making a good decision there.
And when you talk about raw speed and quickness, no one better than De'Aaron Fox.
B.A., if we went into the locker room and looked at the dry erase board, the number one thing up there on the scouting report is beware of De'Aaron Fox in the open court. Such a tremendous finisher and such a great attacker of the basket.
Now here's Fox. The putback.
Sabonis has a great nose to rebound the ball, and then he just sent it back in.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 2 for 5 here in the first. Now here's Melton.
He's coming off a 10-point game against the Hawks in Atlanta. Embiid. Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
Now that's what I call great basketball. Finding a way to get all the way inside.
Man, that's a painted possession right there, a masterpiece, especially when the defense is not a factor.
Here's Fox. Outside Barnes. Pass to Sabonis. Shoots over Embiid. That one rolls around and rims out.
Good idea with the fadeaway, but the defense was just all over it.
And Harris throws it down.
That's a strong finish from Tobias Harris.
Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. And here's Herter. Hasn't gotten one to fall yet. Here's Sabonis. And it's blocked by Embiid.
And he's having an ugly quarter from the field. It seems really frustrated.
Drills it from deep.
An outstanding first quarter from the field.
The Kings have gone 3 of 8 so far. Timeout called. Timeout. The Kings coming off a win against the Hornets.
And as a rule of thumb, the road can really test your team's depth. But they all stepped up and collectively produced a lot of points.
Yeah, and watching that, all kinds of contributions and just little things that guys were doing to chip in for that win.
And some changes here for the 76ers. Oubre comes in for Batum. And it's Beverly in for Maxey. And a new group getting ready for the Kings. Lyles, he's checked in for Murray. Dorte comes in for Barnes. Monk, he's checked in for Herter. And Mitchell subbed in for De'Aaron Fox. Six seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Mitchell. Oh, the offensive struggles continue. Missing again. Boy, the offense has been on point.
They have great timing and great communication. So hard to get stops against them.
Now here's Oubre. They look to him to score consistently, averaging around 13.5 a game. Just 4 to shoot. No good from the wing.
I admire the play call. They just couldn't capitalize.
Yeah, an efficient offensive possession. They found the look that they wanted, just didn't go in.
Here's Mitchell. 3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Pass to Sabonis. Monk against Melton. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. That one on Melton. Free throw drops for Monk. The Kings making a switch here. Both good from the line that time.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
And that concludes the first quarter of play. The Sixers on top, up four. Don't go away. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a moment. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter of action so far. All right, guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Well, great play down low. I mean, you expect the defense to adjust, collapse maybe, but that should open up things on the perimeter later in the game.
Love the passing that they displayed at the start of the game. Great ball movement that's opening up some chances without really getting deep into the execution.
On the court for the Kings, second quarter underway. Fox and Monk, they're the guards. Trey Lyles is out there with Alex Lynn. And it's Dorte in at the small forward position. Drains the triple. The three-point shot changed the game, clearly. But did you see it becoming the centerpiece of so many teams' offense, Brent?
I think it was inevitable in a way, B.A., but the way it got introduced to the league and the way that the 7 seconds or less Phoenix Suns adapted to the three-point line and then eventually what the Rockets were doing, it kind of came in like a flood. And each year we're seeing more and more guys who you wouldn't think should be shooting threes now capable of not only taking them but making them. And so that goes for every position. That makes the game very dangerous.
Fox against Beverly. Here's Morris. Count it. One for one to start the game.
And how about the quick shot there from Morris, not allowing the defense to get anywhere near him.
Fox surveying the D. To the paint. It's Monk on the wing. Puts it up from the high post. Here's Lynn. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. Kelly Oubre picks one up.
Yeah, he's going to be in the paint is Alex Lynn, and he's good at forcing the defense to come in and take some chances. Whacked him that time.
First one falls for him. The 76ers making a switch here. Batum's checked in. Murray's checked in for Sacramento. Herter comes in for Dorte. And he makes the first but misses the second. The Sixers leading. To the inside. Batum finds Maxey. Great D that time from Murray.
That's the only kind of defense that's going to cut the mustard here tonight. You got to stay on top of a guy like that who can play at such a high level offensively.
Now here's Fox. 5 points in the game. Now that we're into the new year, how about a check on the Eastern Conference standings? Taking a look at Philadelphia, here around the midway point, they've proven to be a top three team in their conference.
Checking out Philadelphia, they just have serious hopes for the outcome of this season. They're focused on putting up a banner.
A massive amount of confidence, tremendous swagger with this team, and they believe in themselves. That might be all it takes to get them where they want to go.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for the Sixers. Melton comes in for Beverly. A moment to hear from Ali LaForce.
Joel Embiid talked about setting the tone. He said, it's not easy being a leader. I'm not an off-the-court guy. I'm more reserved. But on the court, I show up. That's the way I like to lead, dominating on the court, offensively, defensively, and try to bring everybody along with me. Brian?
He does it well, for sure. Allie, thanks for that. The fourth overall pick of the 2022 draft. Keegan Murray had a great rookie season, Brent.
Well, the Kings identified an older prospect in the draft, and it was exactly what that team needed. A presence on the floor that was calming, one that could shoot, one that could defend, and one that could move the ball. And then all of a sudden, Keegan Murray has the Kings in the playoffs in that role.
Here's Lyles. In his last outing, 8 points for him. Pass to Fox. Beyond the arc. And Joel Embiid pulls it down. Embiid's got four rebounds now. Maxey against Fox. Now Embiid. Boy, you look at his scoring average of 34.5 points a game. Very impressive. Late clock. The Sixers need to put one up here. Great open look there. And now a 12-point Philadelphia lead.
Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
Timeout called. Sacramento.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tie?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
Harris has checked in for Oubre. Domantas Sabonis, he's checked in for Sacramento. Harrison Barnes comes in for Fox. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Monk against Maxey. Here's Herter. Nice start for him, sinking his first shot.
It was a rough start for them scoring the ball, but they look like now they're really finding their rhythm and flow.
Maxey passes to Embiid. Melton against Herter. Embiid with it. Pass to Maxey. Five on the clock. The three ball. Offensive board. No stopping Joel Embiid. Wow.
And the team counts on Embiid for this, to grab loose balls and send them right back.
Sabonis with it. Sabonis with a screen on Melton. Here's Herter. And it's blocked by Embiid. Batum against Barnes. Maxey surveys. Embiid finds Maxey. Back to Embiid. It's Embiid going to work inside.
I'll tell you what, they are on fire this quarter, taking total command of this game.
Sacramento has gone 1 of 2 from deep in the second quarter. Outside Monk. To the middle. Here's Sabonis. They kick it out to Murray. That Portland falls. Nice feed from Sabonis. Murray's got 5 points in the quarter.
If you leave someone open on a team with Sabonis having the ball, he's going to make you pay. That's great recognition.
And so it's Philadelphia closing out the quarter ahead by 11 points. What has them in front right now, by and large, they're taking great shots. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Joel, the reserves have been awesome so far. What are you seeing from them?
The bench has helped us a lot. They've come in, they've scored the ball, they've got to stop, so we're going to need them to keep it going.
Helps to have backup. Good luck in the second half.
Allie, as always, thank you. We'll be right back to begin the third quarter right after this.
Howdy, folks. The moment you've been waiting for is here. Before we recap the first half, let's see what the standings look like in the East.
Taking a look here now at the 76ers. I had them as a top team before the season, and now I'm picking them to make the finals. Tell me I'm wrong, Kenny. You can't, because I'm right. 2 plus 2 is 5.
And as much as it pains me, I have to agree with Big Fella.
And now, guys, let's talk about that first half. The story thus far has been the play of one Joel Embiid.
Embiid, you guys, embarrassing defenders. An electric performance for him tonight. He put this team on his back.
All the love to the big man. He's getting it done in every way tonight.
Thanks for tuning in. Now it's time to head back over to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. What else can you say? Joel Embiid, an impressive effort here today.
When he got good position and they got the ball to him, he was automatic.
Yeah, we'll see if the double teams start to come here in the second half to make them adjust offensively, but he's going to keep going at him.
Maxi runs point with Melton at the two. Harris and Embiid are in the middle, and it's Batum in at the three spot. That's the group for Nick Nurse, getting going here in the second half. And so it's Barnes with it. He brings it up for the Sacramento Kings. They trail by 11. Sabonis, the pass to Fox. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
How about De'Aaron Fox just staying focused there with the finish? Controlled that one well.
Philadelphia has gone 5 of 10 from beyond the three-point line in this game. And Maxey, here we go. Harris outside. Screen by Embiid. Harris passes to Batum. Just 5 on the clock. Embiid, a screen on Herter. From deep, Melton. Can't hit that one. The Kings trailing. Fox outside. Takes a three. Batum pulls it in. Philadelphia's gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Here's Maxey. The Sixers again can't hit.
Stumbling to start the second half. 3 straight misses.
Right around a minute and a half played in the third quarter. Fox, the pass to Sabonis. Embiid with a steal. Pass break, Philadelphia. Oh, Embiid packs it down.
Yeah, Embiid can throw it down from anywhere. So much power for the big fella.
Well, the Kings shooting 44%, a pretty decent clip. Murray, a screen on Maxey. Here's Fox. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
And he makes a first. And you know, there's so much coaching turnover in the NBA, Brent. Why do you think that is?
If you examine BA, some of those changes, look at the ownership changes that has happened within two or three seasons of a coach being released from his duties from a team. So these owners want to put into place maybe the style of play that they want from a different coach. And when that happens, it's about results, and about those results being too immediate. It's causing a lot of change, and it makes that job a little bit more tenuous than it was in the past.
Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Hey, Brian. Well, the Sixers have so much firepower, but it's all about chemistry. Anyone knows the way teams grow is by talking and being around each other. The connection between the stars is what's going to help them reach their peak. Brian?
Well, they've had to deal with some adjustments for sure. Allie, thanks. Now here's Herter. Checking his stats, he's scoring around 9.5 points per game. Kicks it out to Barnes. 6 on the shot clock. Down low. And Sabonis slams it in.
Sabonis just rolling right into that perfect pocket position off the pick and roll.
Here's Maxey. Consistent production from him, averaging just over 26 a game. Harris, a screen on Fox. Here's Maxey. And the layup is good off the glass. Maxey's got 5.
And despite the height disadvantage, oh my, he just attacks that interior.
Yeah, no stopping him on that play. Sometimes even the taller defenders are helpless to stop him.
You watch Harrison Barnes, Brent. He's a steadying influence out there.
I feel like Harrison Barnes has been an example for younger players since he was, in fact, a younger player. PA. I mean, this guy goes about his business as a professional night in and night out.
Now here's Harris. Outside Maxey. The 3 is up. The rebound by Murray.
Not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
Barnes passes to Sabonis. And Sabonis slams it in.
That's a pretty easy opportunity for a teammate, all courtesy of Harrison Barnes.
So it's Philadelphia now. And Philadelphia calls time here. Covington's checked in for the Sixers. Oubre comes in for Melton. And the Kings will go for a different look here. Lyles, he's checked in for Murray. Dorte comes in for Barnes. Monk, he's checked in for Herter. And Mitchell subbed in for Fox. And here are the Sixers now. 6-point game. Maxey against Mitchell. Harris, a screen on Mitchell. For three, Maxey buries it from three. Maxey's got eight.
And trying more and more to utilize the three-pointer. It's a good idea. That's his second three of the game. One in each half.
Mitchell, the pass to Duarte. Here's Lyles. And they waste no time getting those 3 points back. Lyles has gotten himself going with a triple, his first basket of the game. There's 42 seconds left in the third quarter. Pass to Oubre. Harris on the wing. Batum, right side. And here's Oubre. For three, here's Harris. Hits a three-pointer. Give him eight.
Well, early in his career, defenses challenged Tobias Harris to take this shot. Now they don't want him to, for good reason.
Here's Duarte. Lyles, the pass to Sabonis. Outside for Mitchell. Shot clock at six. Here's Duarte. Back to Lyles. Fires the three. He can't get it to go. And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers. They have a nice 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Their play has earned them a nice lead, one they'll look to build on as the game continues. Time for a quick break, then back to the action. And while we have a chance, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
Just a selfless decision from your two guard, showing his ability to get his teammates good looks.
What an advantage if your off guard can make plays so valuable.
With three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store. Taking a look at Sacramento. Fox and Monk, they're the guards. Then it's Trey Lyles. Then it's Chris Duarte. And it's Vezinkov in at the four. It's Monk on the wing. Lyles a screen. Unloads. And the basket by Monk.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
And the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort got burned on that one.
Now here's Morris. Back to Beverly. And that comes off the assist by Morris. Beverly's gotten his first points in this one.
And Morris doing a good job of scanning the floor and realizing when his teammate was open.
And so it's Fox with it. He'll bring it up for the Sacramento Kings. They trail by nine. Great D that time from Beverly.
There's a little bit of pressure on him, but not enough to cause him to miss a shot that's in that close.
And the shot goes in.
Can't lay off Oubre that far. He's good at taking advantage of that separation.
Here's Monk, following the score by Philadelphia. Lyles, the pass to Fox. Philadelphia grabs the miss. They've led by as many as 14. Pass to Beverly. We've gone about a minute and a half into this fourth quarter. Inside, here's Martin, and he dunks it down.
Nice vision there from Morris, keeping his eyes up.
The Kings have gotten just one shot to fall out of three attempts in the fourth. Timeout called, Sacramento.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tide?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
And it's a completely new group for the 76ers. Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Mike Brown was saying to the team. He told his guys to, quote, turn it up, going on to say, only way we get out of this hole is with effort, incredible effort. So show me what you can do out there. It's a big ask, but we'll see what happens. Back to you.
Thank you for that, Allie. Here's Sabonis. Pass to Barnes. And there's the foul. It's on Joel Embiid. That's his first foul of the game. Philadelphia on D. A great fourth quarter. Just giving up 2 points.
Tough matchup here, and Fox has it going right now. The lefty getting some room and making it happen.
Now here's Melton. Pass to Harris. Herter against Melton. Harris, a screen on Herter. Here's Melton. That one rolls around and rims out.
And when he's this close, he's got to make it. The defense was pretty good, but just shouldn't miss that.
Fox against Maxey. Now here's Fox. The D's right on him. Give him that one. Now shooting 5 for 11 from the floor.
How about that? Just accepting the contact and still getting the finish for Fox.
If you're just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Pass to Embiid. Melton outside. From outside the arc. It's rebounded by Sabonis. The Kings have gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. Fox outside. Murray, a screen on Maxey. Here's Fox. Fox can't get that one to fall. Grant, wouldn't be a bad idea here to slow it down.
Yeah, coach is definitely looking for patience and execution.
Here's Maxey. The Sixers again can't hit.
That's a shot he'd like back. He's usually going to make those.
Melton against Herter. And he drops it in from the low post.
Known for being a scorer, Herter is good at staying active and then looking to capitalize inside.
Philadelphia's got 7 of their 16 three-point attempts to go in. Melton passes to Embiid. And then Embiid with the dunk.
This is what he gives you night in and night out. Stellar production at the offensive end.
There's 1:17 left in the final quarter. Fox against Maxey. Outside Herter. Lets the 3 fly. The basket's good. Off the assist from Fox.
That's a crucial basket, and Herter big time.
It in off the pretty lob.
Nice touch on both ends of that alley-oop.
Hey, when he let go of the pass, I had no idea what he was going for. And Fox has got the ball here for Sacramento. 8-point game. Outside Murray. Pass to Herter. Back to Murray. The 3. Money. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
You see why the coaching staff trusts Murray. That's a big shot.
Trying here to put the game out of reach.
And that's why it's important to play this one smart.
And so they foul intentionally. Now here's Maxey. Sabonis on the double team. Pass to Harris. And Harris throws it down.
Really feels like they're in control. They've got a big lead, but time dwindling.
Yeah, looking for a miracle worker out there is the opposing coaching staff. I don't know that they have one. This game seems to be well in hand.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. They're down by 7. 34 seconds left in the fourth quarter. All right, guys, what do you think?
They're going to have to get up a quick shot and then foul immediately.
Maxey against Fox. Outside Barnes. The three is up. Yes! And now they trail by just four.
And the team turning their attention to Harrison Barnes. And for good reason.
Good on the first, and that puts him up five. So he gets them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
You can't afford to waste any chances at this stage of the game. That means you got to hit your free throws.
Time called here. The Kings decide to talk it over. They're down by six. 26 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter of this one. Twenty-six seconds left in the fourth. Fox finds Sabonis. Baseline try. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. They've led by as many as 14. And that's an intentional foul.
Yeah, and there's no question they have to foul. Now, I'm sure they would have preferred to avoid it.
He gets the first, and that makes it a seven-point lead. And so he drops them both, and it's an eight-point ball game. 16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. It's stolen by Maxey. It's Philadelphia picking up the win. This one was a fun one to watch. They were clearly in the driver's seat down the stretch.
They really were, B.A. They played with great intensity on both ends of the floor, and they didn't allow their mistakes to get the better of them.
All right, let's send it down to Allie LaForce, who's with our player of the game.
Joel, you took over offensively. What went into finding that rhythm?
I thought I got the shots that I wanted, and I played into the flow of the offense, and my teammates were finding me, so I just knocked down some shots.
Thanks, Joel.
All right, Allie, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. As we present our New Balance Player of the Game, Joel Embiid.